shallow, meaning that a lot of people are getting paid in non-commercial means, meaning that they get help otherwise through the barter exchanges or through help later on. Here, this is customs broker's exam, right? It really goes to the bottom line, straight commercial transaction. So when you're talking unpaid, means there is no contract, implied, explicit or implicit, verbal or written, and you're just doing it out of your goodwill, let's say for the church. So this brings us down to nominal consignee, who, as we all saw, may not be the importer of record because they are not authorized to file customs. Now, a little sidestep must be taken because nominal consignees include licensed customs brokers. Nominal consignee and licensed broker can be the same thing, but the licensed customs broker, if the licensed customs broker is authorized, then he is an exception to the rule. He is a nominal consignee who is authorized, but if he lacks POA or if he lacks permit, he is not authorized to do that. So this is a list, this is a laundry list of examples. So you have a customs broker who is not permitted, not authorized. We have freight consolidator, the freight forwarder, the trucking company. We have express consignment operator like DHL, UPS, Federal Express, FedEx. And those folks are the listed as examples. So if you are asked on this on a customs broker exam, customs will likely use those examples that they did use on the directive. They will not come up with some kind of new notion. So if you will see some nominal consignee example, it will be the lucky three. So that's easy for you to recognize. The caveat here is a customs broker, because this is kind of fluid. This is a licensed customs broker and he must be permitted. So what happens if you are nominal consignee? You are not authorized. So you are, let's say you are FedEx. You are Federal Express. You are not licensed. You just operate little cars to deliver small packages. What happens? What do you do? Well, if you are nominal consignee who needs to do this as in an express manner, real quickly, and you are not authorized to do that, and you do because, let's say, you don't have a license, you can go and find someone who is licensed. That's the rule. And usually, find someone who is licensed means find someone who is authorized licensed customs broker. So those are the buzzwords, authorized licensed customs broker. And if you find the authorized licensed customs broker, that is the only party outside of having the importer, the owner, I'm sorry, clearing the stuff for themselves. That is the only party pretty much who can do it. But imagine this, imagine the situation. You will not likely to have an owner doing this because think about ordering a Dell computer online. So Dell computer is above 20, let's say I ordered a really nice one, right? Above for $3,000. So that computer is above the informal entry threshold, and the FedEx is a party who is not authorized. Are they gonna call me up and say, well, your shipment is stuck in customs, can you please take care of the paperwork and then we'll deliver it to you? What will happen to their 24-hour business model going with the speed of business? As a customer, I don't wanna hear about, I'm expecting the FedEx guy to show up and give me the stuff, maybe sign for it, and that's it. So I'm expecting FedEx to take care of this as a part of their business model. And this is a tendency. It hasn't been like that all the time. It's only the trend of the past quarter century, I'd say, past 25 years. Before, it was normal for a person who making an overseas purchase to be expected to take care of customs formalities. Now, the mentality has changed, the customer consumer expectations have changed, So, as and the businesses have to adapt. And part of their adaptation, in case of UPS or FedEx, is to hire licensed customs broker or to make a company, a related company, which is licensed, which has a customs broker license. Because customs license, we haven't dwelled into this much, but customs broker license can be given to person as an individual and to the corporation. So you set up a company that is licensed, and if in case of UPS, I believe it's UPS Supply Chain Solutions that is authorized to do this. So the idea for the nominal consignee is they have a way out. They cannot come to customs and deliver their paperwork, but they can hire a licensed customs broker, which is kind of nice as far as the job security is concerned, because there is always need for the licensed customs broker within the United States. And also, a lot of functions of the licensed customs broker, they cannot be outsourced. To clear entry, even electronically, you have to be in the United States doing that. You cannot sit remotely in Canada and clear entries from location in Canada or India, right? You have to be in the United States physically to clear entries. So it's a legal requirement. So it's kind of nice because a lot of jobs, they tend to be outsourced, especially that has been a recent trend for the manufacturing sector. It is happening in the service sector too, but for the licensed profession, this is not likely to happen. Next, let's look at example of how customs examiners test this. So, first, when you see this question, you can see this is kind of a long question. So what you want to do is you want to jump immediately to the question at the end, because this sets up the notion of what you're looking for. And you're looking whether this company, and you notice LLC, right? So when it's LLC, it's most likely it's a corporation doing, which is registered as limited liability company. So you, the customs examiners are asking whether this LLC company can be the importer of record. I think it should be importer of record, so there is a typo, but we understand the point. So then we'll look quickly through the results. Here I make it easy because usually the correct answers are light and bold, and the question here, the focus of the question is on because. Right? So to know whether this LLC company qualifies for importer of record, we have to know the facts. And all of those facts may or may not be true, so we cannot take them for granted. What we have to do is we have to go, now we skim through and we see because, and now we have to figure out, look at the facts that establish the importer of record. We know, what do we know so far? The importer of record can be either licensed customs broker. So we need to see if Speedy Ship is licensed customs broker, and then, or the owner of goods. Otherwise, it's a nominal consignee and cannot do that, right? Oftentimes, also, it's kind of like subconscious point. Customs examiners, they like to play these mind games with you by choosing the funny names. So they will pick up the name as something like as Fuzzy Dreams, or I think the best in the business, or they pick up the name, or they make up the name of the company, such as Customs Broker Enterprises, but implying that this is customs broker, licensed customs broker, but it may be just a name. It may be customs broker for it. It may be just a name without a license attached. Because for most of the time, unless that name has already been taken, or its derogatory name, such as like bad word. And I'm not going to say bad words, but you cannot just use any derogatory names or names that have been taken. Outside of that, everything is free game. You can pretty much pick up any name you like. And there are limits for licensed professions, such as attorneys. I'm not sure that there are limits for licensed customs brokers as corporations. At least I'm not aware of any. So customs capitalizes on that. Here, notice Speedy Ship LLC. When you read the name, do not assume that these guys are in the business of shipping very quickly. Speedy Ship kind of implies it is express consignment operator like FedEx, right? Because they do things really quickly. It may or may not be. I think in this case, it is true. They are the nominal consignee. But in many other cases, it may not be the truth. So by its name alone, just learn to see that as just merely a label and look at the fact pattern, please. And let's look at the facts. And right away, we have a fact. An express consignment operator. That's it. This is all you need. The only thing you need to know, besides this to answer the question below, is whether this express consignment operator is licensed customs broker, which is a possibility. So you read on, looking for license. So you don't even, you can dispose with a label. Oh, look at this. Who is not a licensed customs broker? So customs are keenly aware that this may be the issue. They even tell you, you have express consignment operator, which makes up on the list of nominal consignees. Not a licensed customs broker, so that exception doesn't apply. And if it was a licensed customs broker, let's say they say Speedy Ship LLC was licensed customs broker, then what you're looking for? You're looking for those. So those are the things as you read on. Those are the kind of like a checkpoints that you need to have mentally. So if there was no this was not in a parenthesis, this would be the stuff that you're looking for. Since customs made sure to let you know that they are not licensed and they are express consignment, that's pretty much it. You don't need not read any further. In New York District, so that's really not relevant. So then look, Speedy Ship hires a local licensed customs brokerage to make an entry. So that's fine. Because first of all, it's a local licensed customs broker. They're a licensed customs broker. And so they have a permit because they're local. At least they have a local permit. And if it's a nominal consignee, this is the way it's done. They go to the licensed customs broker who is authorized. So we know they have a permit because it says local. And provides the broker with the power of attorney. So power of attorney is given. The broker then, look at this. The broker prepares the entry document. So they do the right stuff with a Speedy Ship. But in the importer of record box, on the entry documents, on the customs entry documents, they say this guy, Speedy Ship LLC, is the importer of record. Sounds like the licensed customs broker who hasn't been paying attention to the rules. What's wrong with that statement? The broker prepares the entry documents where it is identified as an importer of record and prepares continuous custodial bond. So I'm not sure what's custodial bond. It can be, it may or may not be relevant. When it can be relevant?
IT.
Yeah, because you don't need to be licensed customs broker. You don't need to have a license to prepare shipment for immediate transportation. Mm-hmm. But look, here we are not talking about IT. We are talking about entry. When you see that entry combined with entry document, that means entry for consumption or entry for the warehouse. Go back to the general rules. 102 general provisions. They have a definition. They have a clear definition. Entry. When if they say entry, this means entry for the warehouse or entry for the consumption. So we know by this word, this is not for IT. This is not this situation. This is not this one. If it was, it would be okay. But how else can you use continuous bond? I just said it. Continuous bond is fine. When? I'm sorry, custodial bond. Custodial bond is to hold things in a custody, and besides holding it in a custody when you track it or rail it from one place to another, you can hold it in a custody as a warehouse person. Warehouses, if you go back to our bonds discussion, are also type of individuals or type of entities that need custodial bond, not a single entry bond, not the continuous bond, continuous consumption bond, but activity would be custodial bond. So this is probably the warehouse, because this combined with this can only go for the warehouse, right? And to make the entry for the warehouse is an entry, so you need to have an importer of record, full-fledged importer of record, correct? Make sense? So this is the stuff, this is the mental processes that should be going on in the background. So the next question is, should LLC be the importer of record for the shipment? Well, the answer is no, because, first of all, Speedy Ship LLC is the express consignment operator. Second, because they, Speedy Ship LLC, is not tracking it, is not making the immediate transportation entry, but rather making a warehouse entry.